Hello everyone, today we have the third viewer-made malware video. This is a Trojan and file-infecting virus hybrid called Mist, written by Mistake. And this is actually really cool, so thank you very much for writing this and sending it in. I'm pretty excited to demonstrate this on video. So first things first, we have a few dummy files to look at. First, we have beautiful, beautiful art that I created, a lovely bitmap file, a text document that will eventually be overwritten, and our regular non-infected version of Calculator. Ships with every version of Windows XP. It is 112 kilobytes on the disk, so that's what we're looking for as our base uninfected file size. And one more thing to look at is that blue screens of death are in fact blue and are not any other color. They are regular blue screens of death. And right here, I've just triggered the blue screen of death that you can do with control and scroll lock, just to demonstrate that this works properly. Now let's move on to the virus. Okay, it's time for us to take a look at the actual virus and Trojan. First things first, we're going to run the Mist installer, which will actually install an infected driver to the machine that will then do all the rest of the malware's doings. We'll actually take a look at the file infecting portion next. Remember, Calculator is 112 kilobytes. When we run this, this should be a 3072-byte goat file. However, it's actually not. It's actually 22 kilobytes, so it's definitely been infected by the virus. And now Calc has lost its icon and has grown almost 20 kilobytes, so the size of the virus, to 131 kilobytes. Still works, which is nice. So infected programs do still work. However, they do get infected, of course, and will help spread this virus. And finally, Mist installer RC helps the virus to run on the Windows logon screen, or Windows boot up screen, I believe he said. I'm not really sure if there's too much of a difference between either of these two that would really be important for this video, but we'll take a look at both anyway, just to be sure. Now let's get to the actual payloads of this Trojan virus hybrid thing, whatever you want to call it. First one activates randomly on any day that's not another payload trigger date. So October 20th is a normal day to this virus, will not do anything too malicious, but at a 1% chance opening a bunch of different file types, it will actually block their opening. So we'll go ahead and open this text document until we see that happen. And here we go. Instead of opening our text document like normal, we get a message saying the file or directory is corrupted and unreadable. Which is kind of a bummer, but we can just run it again, and it works. Now we'll move on to the next payload, which activates on the 18th of May. And we'll go ahead and restart after we change the date and see what it does. Okay, we've booted back up, changed the date slightly to the AM hour, just to make sure that it works, and it is May 18th. And now whenever we try to run any of our affected file types, such as text documents, Word documents, PowerPoint, Excel, bitmaps, JPEGs, PNGs, TIFFs, GIFs, all that good stuff. We get the same error message, however, instead of it being a 1% chance, it is a 100% chance. So none of these files will open on May 18th, which in and of itself is not destructive, however, it's rather annoying. But this Trojan virus hybrid thing only gets worse from here, so let's continue on. 15th of December, this will actually start leaking memory. Which is actually pretty entertaining, so we'll go ahead and restart, wait a little bit, and see what this ends up doing. Okay, so we've booted up the computer on the 18th, or I mean on the 15th of December, excuse me, and it's been about 5 minutes since we booted, and we are really running out of available memory here. I've reduced the memory available to the virtual machine to 256 megabytes, and completely removed the page file, so things are not looking too good for this virtual machine. As we can see, we have programs crashing, we're out of virtual memory, and it's just generally not going well. Left unchecked, this will eventually cause the machine to hang or perform rather erratically and sluggishly. Since this is a virtual machine running on a solid-state drive, we're not going to see too much of a performance decrease unless we really sit here for a while. But imagine on a physical machine running these kind of specs. As we can see, the page files full, since it doesn't really exist, it would really lag it, and it would become very sluggish. So we'll move on to the next payload, which is actually quite dangerous and activates on the 18th of April. So go ahead and change the date and restart, and we'll see what happens after the computer boots back up. Okay, we're booted into the computer. The data set properly. Let's take a look at this dangerous payload. Now, normally opening and closing text documents or bitmaps or HTML or HTML, JavaScript, pretty much a lot of programming language files, opening and closing will be perfectly fine. We can open and close it as much as we want. Nothing happens. But say you're writing a program, like a C++ or C or assembly program. Oh no, that's bad. And we save it. Okay, we're running out of memory again for some reason, but that's okay. Oh god, what's happening? Okay, this is unrelated to, this is not related to Myst, but that's kind of funny. Let's get back to the virus. So now that we've edited this and changed it and saved the changes, when we open it back up, our documents are overwritten with gibberish instantly. So as soon as any save is applied to any file, it gets overwritten. So say you're working on a huge project, you save your changes, try to compile, and your code is dead. Hopefully you have backups. We're gonna edit my beautiful artwork here. I'm gonna add some cool spray can green. And of course we're gonna save that, because I mean it's modern art. And we're gonna try and open it again. And our bitmap has been turned into garbage data. Which admittedly looks kinda cool, but I mean it's not my art. And I was kind of attached to that, so I'm kinda sad now. But moving right along, we're moving on to the last payload, which overwrites your master boot record, which is actually pretty neat. So we're gonna change the date once again to the 30th of September. And restart, and we should see it happen. So we're booting up on the 30th of September. And eventually, the virus payload should start up. There it is. So we get a nice song. Computer is still usable while this is happening. As soon as the song is done, computer crashes to a blue screen of death. However, this virus has changed it so that all blue screens of death are now red. So we have the red screen of death with the error message OX dead dead. So that's kind of scary. We'll go ahead and restart the computer now. And we will see that the MBR has been overwritten with this really cool graphical colored scrolling rainbow thing. It's actually really neat. And it will do this whenever you boot your computer. Which, you know, is kind of bad if you wanted to use your computer, but for this channel, this is pretty cool. And one hidden feature from the author mistake. If you hit R, it actually replaces your boot record with the clean copy and allows you to reboot your PC back to normal. However, if you do it again today, it will just play the song again and overwrite your master boot record again. So pretty much waiting till tomorrow, like it says, will be the best plan of action. So that is about it for the Myst Trojan virus hybrid thing, as I keep calling it. If you'd like to see more information about it, or view the source code, or the author's write-up on his website, please check out the link in the description. If you'd like to send in your own malware, or Trojan, or virus, or whatever, to be featured in one of these videos, please check out my forum link in the description, and read the guidelines. See if that's something you might want to do. Thank you all once again for watching. If you're enjoying these videos, please let me know. And yeah, thank you. That's about it.